Wij zijn gevangen genomen door Dr. Gebhard.
Dat klopt.
En het is nu aan ons om te ontsnappen.
Ja.
Maar we zitten vastgebonden in een rolstoel.
We zijn ook een beetje gedrogeerd.
Ja, dat klopt. We kunnen ook niks. Ah, we kunnen wel iets. Een pair of scissors. Ook hardop praten, dat is handig.
Enough of that, Mr. Zerna. Soon it will all be behind you.
Dr. Gebhard. Oeh, we worden ingespoten.
Is dat vervelend?
Met blauwe suspensie.
Ja.
I am sorry you have to see all this.
Maar we beginnen weer opnieuw. Ah, we moeten dus iets anders
we moeten
aanpakken.
Iets doen in, die, in dit tijdsbestek inderdaad. Ja.
Oké, en dat is dus niet... Oh, wacht.
Chloroform? I had it in my bag, just in case. You were supposed to be asleep. I am not a monster, you know?
Hij is niet een monster.
Het is wel een vervelende man.
Nothing at all. But what can I do? You forced my hand. It's your fault. Yours alone. Keep talking. Heart failure happens a lot at your age, especially given your background.
Ah.
I am still considering whether I should throw you overboard. Don't leave evidence. No evidence. But what if I'm seen? My plan was perfect. And then you ruined everything. On and on.
Blijf praten.
Why? 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 Why did the Baroness have to snoop around? Why did you have to snoop around? And that glove there. You want to plant evidence on me, yeah?
Die handschoen. Die hebben wij daar niet ingelegd.
Nee.
Die hebben wij daar gevonden.
Klopt.
On and on.
Kunnen we daar iets over zeggen? Nee. Ja, dan is dit toch echt het enige wat we kunnen, lijkt het.
Ja.
Oh, dit is chloroform. Die bruine fles.
Dus wij kunnen niet iets doen.
Nee, ik kan alleen bij die schaar komen. Maar als ik die pak... Oh, nu gaan we wel terug.
Kunnen we met die schaar nog iets anders doen?
Ja, ik heb niks in mijn...
Die fles omgooien ofzo?
Nee, ik kan niet bij die fles. Ik kan het ding in zijn rug gooien? Nee. Cut the straps.
Oh. Dat lijkt me wel een slim idee.
Oh, we gaan... Oh. Dit werkt niet.
Take it easy, Mr. Zellner.
Nou, daar gaan we weer.
You will only hurt
blijkbaar hebben we wel meer tijd.
Shall we begin?
Als we met hem praten.
Ja.
No.
Hé, hey, ik heb hier de tijd om ergens op te drukken. Zag je dat?
Ja.
We hadden tijd om iets in te drukken. Daar. Maar goed, dan moeten we wel een item hebben. Want die schaar hadden we ook laten. Ah, nu komen we hier terug.
Ja, misschien weer pakken of zo.
Ik kan hier nu niks. Daar ligt iets op de grond, of niet? Nee. Dat is gewoon een blauwtje. Of ligt er wel iets?
Take it easy, Mr. Zelna. You will only hurt yourself.
Ja, use a syringe.
It's almost over.
Hier.
I will.
De syringe hem. Iemand helpt ons.
Lekker hoor. Are you
okay? Het was die gevangene, leek het vanaf de achterkant.
Ja. Yeah.
We leven. We leven.
Het publiek.
A wet towel works miracles. I told you so.
Out with it then. What were you doing down there?
Inspector, at least let the constable recover his breath.
He almost killed himself.
Me? No. Dr. Gebhardt would have taken care of that for me. Where is he?
Gebhardt? He's vanished without a trace. We're searching the ship from top.
Waar kan hij zijn?
One at a time. Tell me, Zelda. What did you find out?
Dr. Gebhardt killed Baroness von Trebitz.
Impossible.
Do you have proof?
Besides the fact that he wanted to kill me?
But wasn't the doctor with you when the shot was fired?
Shot came from the tape. Yeah.
That's good,
the
yeah.
The shot that we heard was a recording. The Baroness had a tape recorder and good speakers in her cabin. Good enough to make the noise audible on the upper deck.
Is that just your suspicion? Or do you have proof?
There's an audio tape in the medical center. The reel belongs to the tape player in the Baroness's cabin. And there's a sibling reel in her cabin that belongs to the recorder in the medical center. He recorded it in the cargo hold. His tape recorder has a microphone
in the cargo hold.
And I removed the opname from one of the boxes down there.
And it came from the murder weapon?
All right.
Is mom.
Inspector Legrand.
Met. Boat.
Let's pretend you're onto something. The shot we heard was just a recording. What happened next?
We all ran to the Baroness's cabin. She lay comatose in a pool of blood. Dr. Gebhardt pushed past you so that you couldn't get too close to the Baroness. He examined her and pronounced her dead. There was no reason for us to doubt him. The shot, the blood, the Baroness lying there lifelessly. But she was only unconscious. Knocked out by the chloral hydrate that the doctor had poured into her glass shortly before.
The doctor had a glass in his hand when you came in.
He wanted to remove the evidence. But you gave me the glass instead, Captain De Conti, and unintentionally knocked me out as well.
Nonsense. There was blood everywhere. And the Baroness is certainly dead enough, isn't she?
Then who did shoot her? And when?
She was poisoned. Yeah.
She wasn't shot. She was poisoned.
And yet I saw the hole in her chest with my own eyes.
Aha!
She must have been shot.
Well, ingenious. Where was she shot?
In the cabin? Ja, daar leek het wel op, hè? Nee, want dat bloed was niet echt.
Nee, dat klopt. Dat was...
As I already said, it was Dr. Gebhardt. He had the sleeping Baroness brought to the medical center. Where he had all the time in the world to shoot her.
A fine theory, but unfortunately incorrect. I examined the Baroness before she was taken away. She had a bullet wound in her chest.
Besides which, she was already cold when we brought her to the medical center.
All the same, it's worth considering the possibility. The doctor was alone in the cabin for a while. When the alarm went off, it was deafening. I couldn't even hear myself.
And I found a pillow with burn marks. Could have been used to muffle a gunshot.
And the blood?
The blood wasn't real. Dr. Gebhardt mixed up a liquid that looked like fresh blood to the casual observer, but the liquid remained red instead of becoming darker and browner from exposure to the air.
Mm.
That meant he had to clean the body and get rid of the bedding.
But the blood was already there when we first entered the cabin.
Dr. Gebhardt was in the Baroness's cabin before the murder.
Yeah.
He hid a surgical glove full of the red liquid under her sheet. The Baroness, dead tired, fell onto her bed. The glove burst and the blood spread across the bed. I found the burst glove in the medical center.
But why did he do it?
That's what was his motive?
Inspector?
Goeie vraag.
Ja.
Ik denk de tweede.
Ik denk het ook.
The Baroness was blackmailing Dr. Gebhardt.
What's your reasoning?
Isn't blackmail always a good motive?
It's worthless without proof.
Ah, daar gaat het om de eye of the Sphinx.
It had to do with the eye of the Sphinx. The Baroness was supposed to bring one of the keys to Cairo.
So Dr. Gebhardt was the raven?
I don't think so. But perhaps he was working with him.
No, want no,
dokter
no.
Gebhardt die gaf aan dat hij niet wist van die handschoenen.
Dat klopt. Die zei dat wij dat deden om hem in een slecht daglicht te zetten.
Ja.
Dr. Gebhardt was the raven. It's all here. He admits to everything.
What does it say?
It says, do you still remember, my dear Nico? The streets were wet with rain and the scent of roasted barley and fermenting yeast wafted over to us from the brewery. The dog barked until your shot struck down the innocent one. After that silence, not a single sound, except for my soft steps fading on the wet cobblestone street. They made a hero of you, and I, at last, found peace. At least until the urge returned. Some of us are not made for retirement, my friend. I thought they would assign this case to you, and that thought pleased me. We'd finally find out who was truly the better man. And it pains me now to have to admit that you and your little gumshoe got the better of me. You drove me into a corner, forced me to make mistakes. I congratulate you on your triumph, but no one will confine the raven to a cage. There is but one way out, and that is by my own hand. Farewell, Raven Hunter, R.
Inspector Legrand.
Ja, dit is allemaal erg toevallig.
Klopt.
Erg toevallig.
Inspector?
I was right. I told them all over and over again. But no one would listen.
Dr. Gebhardt.
You think that Dr. Gebhardt was really the raven?
The things Gebhardt describes in his letter aren't part of any police report. Only someone who was there would know them.
Couldn't there have been others involved? One of the police, for instance. What if one of them changed sides?
Why is it so hard for you to accept the simple truth? There was never a new raven.
Hij wil het wel heel graag.
Ik denk nog steeds dat hij hetzelfde is.
That was Dr. Gebhardt. Yeah.
The modus operandi doesn't match. The raven was not
of die,
a killer.
Die agent van hem.
Legends are rarely what they seem to be, Constable Zellner.
What about the handwriting, the wording? Does the farewell letter match the raven's other letters?
Yes, it's his handwriting, his words. I've read all the raven's letters, all of them. Over and over again.
I never thought it was possible. A resurrected raven.
The raven was never dead. I shot the wrong man.
But that man had the stolen goods, didn't he? So he must have been in league with the raven. One could hardly call him innocent. Then who was the man who was killed back then?
William Jackson, a petty thief, committed some burglaries together with his brother. Talented, but not world-class.
And they thought he was the raven.
Some people thought it was part of his disguise. If you're a debonair master thief, what better disguise than pretending to be a common crook? From time to time, you let them catch you, pulling small jobs, and no one ever imagines you're capable of a major heist.
But you didn't believe it.
I had my doubts. But everyone congratulated me, and those doubts were pushed aside. It was like being caught in a storm. But eventually the storm passed, and my doubts were still there.
But not this time? No doubts telling you that Gebhardt isn't our man?
It must be him.
Where do we go from here?
We deliver the Eye and then I'll contact Perry. A task force will compare all of Gebhardt's known residences with the Raven's activity.
And if there are any inconsistencies?
You're welcome to keep an eye on the safe if you can't let it go. The ship will remain in Cairo for one day. That's all the time you'll have to catch your own Raven. I already have mine.
Dat gaat natuurlijk gebeuren.
Ja, dat denk ik ook. Ah, we komen in Cairo aan.
Ah, you're one of Legrand's men, aren't you?
My name is Anton Jakob Zellner.
You've come just in time. Grace, my dachshund is missing.
There may be more important matters for me to attend to, Mr...
Director Abbas Mokhtar. And Grace isn't just a common dog. She's a purebred German dachshund, a champion.
Okay.
So, the exhibition will still open tonight.
But of course, everything has been arranged. The final preparations are almost complete.
But one of the two exhibits won't be there.
A terrible loss, a tragedy. That irreplaceable Egyptian cultural treasure has been stolen for the second time.
The second time?
What? Did you really believe that the Eye of the Sphinx was found lying on the banks of the Thames?
Inspector Legrand, Professor Lucien, and Constable Oliver are overseeing the transportation of the safe. They should be here at any moment. I'll have a look around in the meantime.
Do you think that's necessary? The Raven is dead, after all.
If you mean Dr. Gebhardt, his body was never recovered. Nor the stolen Eye of the Sphinx, for that matter.
It does us a great honor that the Inspector is concerned about us. But we have everything under control.
Legrand isn't as concerned as he should be. But I am. Is the museum closed?
Yes. Only carefully selected guests may enter the museum during preparations for the gala. And of course, you're one of them, Mr. Constable.
What can you tell me about the museum's security system?
One of the best on the market. And the second eye will still be exhibited in our special treasure chamber, which is extra secure.
Treasure chamber?
See for yourself, to the right of the entrance. The eye is as safe as the British crown jewels.
Okay. I think I'll have a look around the museum.
Please do. There's a lot to see. And you'll let me know if you see Grace, won't you? I hope we find her before the great inspector arrives. Isn't it fantastic how he solved the murder on the ship?
Legrand?
Of course. It's in all the newspapers.
Uiteraard.
The murder of the wealthy Baroness von Trebitz. And how the great Inspector Legrand identified the murderer in just one day. It's the stuff legends are made of. You should count yourself lucky to have the chance to learn from him.
What exactly do the newspapers say?
Yeah.
Everything. It's fantastic. Someone on board must have informed the press immediately. Of course, it's a great advertising for us. The reporters will queue up tonight.
And it was reported that Legrand found the murderer.
Of course. Who else?
Well, I wasn't exactly uninvolved.
Of course. Legrand surely has assistants, but honor to he who deserves to be honored, right?
Well then.
Be seeing you, Constable. Grace. Here, Gracie. My sweetheart.
Hey, butler.
Where are you?
Oh, Mr. Inch.
Mr. Inch. There you are. I am so sorry. Baroness von Trebitz was a good-hearted woman. She did so much for the museum.
As you say, sir.
And you? Are you leaving so soon?
I'd like to go back to my hotel. These last days have been such a strain.
First, you sneak into the museum without greeting me, and then you want to leave just as quickly?
I didn't want to disturb you, and we'll have time enough tonight.
Yes, you simply must come tonight. I wanted to present Baroness von Trebitz with a medal. Now you'll have to accept it.
Of course, if you insist, sir.
The Baroness paid for all this. Without her, there wouldn't have been an exhibition or a gala.
She was very generous.
Yes, she was.
If you'll excuse me now. Constable Zellner, I want to thank you again for all you've done. You saved me, you could say.
My pleasure. See you tonight.
We nemen ook wel vandaag.
Ja. Ik ook wel.
Ik vind iedereen vandaag eigenlijk.
Dat is op zich een goede hout.
Zo komen we aan in het museum. Dan kunnen wij hier deze video denk ik afronden. En dan gaan we in de volgende video het museum betreden.
Dat denk ik ook.
Dus graag. Tot dan.
Tot dan, joejoe.
Joejoe.